A very good morning to all of you. This is seventh video from the same unit, polynomials. And here in this video, I will discuss the different types of problems which are expected for and important for your board point of view. And here in the first type of question, it is on finding the values of symmetric expressions involving zeros of a quadratic polynomial. And here we have, if alpha and beta are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial fx is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, then evaluate in first alpha square plus beta square, second it is alpha by beta plus beta by alpha, third it is alpha cube plus beta cube, fourth 1 by alpha cube plus 1 by beta cube, and fifth it is alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha. One by one, I will solve all these subtopics. So, here is the solution. It is given here that alpha and beta are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial fx. So, we have sum of its zeros is equal to minus b by a, that is alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. And product of its zeros, alpha into beta is equal to c by a. Using these two values, we can find subtopic 1. And in subtopic 1, we have to find alpha square plus beta square. We can write it as alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. So, in right hand side, using the value of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta, we have minus b by a whole square minus 2c by a. Taking a square as the LCM, we have in the numerator b square minus 2ac. Therefore, alpha square plus beta square is equal to b square minus 2ac by a square. Moving ahead, in subtopic 2, we are supposed to find alpha by beta plus beta by alpha. So, taking alpha into beta as the LCM, we have in the numerator alpha square plus beta square. And in subtopic 1, we have calculated alpha square plus beta square. So it can be written as alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. And in denominator, we have alpha into beta. Putting the values of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta, we have minus b by a whole square minus 2 into c by a divided by c by a. So after simplification, simplify here carefully. We have in the numerator b square minus 2ac and in denominator ac. Therefore, alpha by beta plus beta by alpha is equal to b square minus 2ac by ac. Moving ahead, subtopic 3, we are supposed to find alpha cube plus beta cube. Using the identity AQ plus BQ, we will write it here as alpha cube plus beta cube is equal to alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 into alpha into beta in bracket alpha plus beta. Therefore, in right hand side, using the values of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta, we have minus b by a whole cube minus 3 into c by a. In bracket, it is minus b by a. So we have minus bq by aq plus 3bc by a square. Taking aq as LCM, we have in the numerator minus bq plus 3abc. That is, we can write alpha q plus beta q is equal to 3abc minus bq by aq. Subtopic 4, we have to find 1 by alpha cube plus 1 by beta cube. Taking alpha into beta cube as LCM, we have in the numerator alpha cube plus beta cube. We have already calculated in subtopic 3 the value of alpha cube plus beta cube. So we can put that and it is 3abc minus bq by a cube whole divided by c by a whole cube. C by a comes from alpha into beta. So after simplification, a cube and a cube is cancelled. So we are left with 3abc minus b cube by c cube. In fifth subtopic, we have to find alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha. Taking alpha into beta as LCM, we have in the numerator alpha cube plus beta cube. Alpha cube plus beta cube we have already calculated, so we can use that value directly. Otherwise, we can use the identity which we have used in 3. And here was the identity. In place of alpha cube plus beta cube, we can write alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 into alpha into beta in bracket alpha plus beta. And in denominator, we have alpha into beta. Putting the values of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta, we have in the numerator minus b by a whole cube minus 3 into c by a into minus b by a. And in denominator, we have c by a. So after simplification, we are left with 3abc minus b cube divided by a square into c. Therefore, we can say alpha square by beta plus beta square by alpha is equal to 3abc minus b cube whole divided by a square into c. Moving ahead, let us consider another question. And here in this question, it is, if alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial fx is equal to x square plus x minus 2, find the value of 1 by alpha minus 1 by beta. Please be careful, this is also very important. So we can find first in the solution sum of its zeros. We can write alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. And what is the value of b here? It is 1. So we can write minus 1 by 1, which gives us sum of 0 as minus 1. And product of its zeros, alpha into beta, is equal to c by a. And what is c here? It is minus 2. And the a is 1. So it is minus 2 by 1, which gives us minus 2. That is, product of 0 is minus 2. Now we can use the identity alpha plus beta whole square minus beta minus alpha whole square is equal to 4 alpha beta. When we are going to simplify this using the identity a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b, we will get this. This can, after simplification, also be written as beta minus alpha whole square is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha beta. This is very important. You may need to use it many a times. Now, putting the values of alpha plus beta and alpha into beta, we have minus 1 whole square minus 4 into minus 2, which gives, after simplification, equal to 9. So we have beta minus alpha whole square is equal to 9. This implies beta minus alpha is equal to square root 9, which gives us 3. We have considered the positive value. Therefore, we can write 1 by alpha minus 1 by beta, taking alpha into beta as the LCM. We are left with in numerator beta minus alpha. Now we have already calculated the value of beta minus alpha, and what it is? It is 3. So we can write 3 by minus 2. Minus 2 comes from alpha into beta. The value of alpha into beta is minus 2. Therefore, we have minus 3 by 2. So we can say alpha by beta minus 1 by alpha minus 1 by beta is equal to minus 3 by 2. Moving ahead, let us consider another question. And here in this question, it is, if alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial fx is equal to x square minus 5x plus k, such that alpha minus beta is equal to 1, find the value of k. So here in this situation, it is given that alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial fx. So we can find sum of its zeros, alpha plus beta is equal to minus 5 by 1, that is minus b by a. So it is 5. And alpha into beta is equal to C by A, which gives from here as K by 1 equal to K. Now, since it is given alpha minus beta is equal to 1, so squaring both the side, what we will get? Alpha minus beta whole square is equal to 1 square, which is also equal to 1. Now, in the last question, we have used this identity. We can write alpha minus beta whole square as alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha into beta. So we have alpha minus beta whole square is equal to alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha beta, and which is equal to 1. Now, taking the value of alpha plus beta, it is equal to 5. So we will write 5 square minus 4 into k. After simplification, we have 25 minus 4k, which is equal to 1, which gives us 24 is equal to 4k, and this implies k is equal to 6. Hence, the value of k is 6. I would request you to solve these all questions. So, there will be no further assignment related to this video. Thank you.